Hi, I am Vijay Rai from Sacred Heart Girls High School, Bangalore. I am in class 3. I am a girl. I can dance, swim, play, cycle, and win prizes in academics. All this is possible because I have got equal opportunity. I am thankful to my parents and my teachers for making my childhood full of good experience. I hope each and every girl gets the same opportunity. My message to all the girls, be the girl who turns her cannots into can, have nots into have, dreams into plan, mistakes into success. My role model is Mrs. Sudha Murthy. I admire for her simplicity and humility. She is my idol because she was the only girl among 599 boys in her engineering college. She motivates us to dream big, to dream unique, and to achieve it. My voice, our future. Thank you.
Hi everyone. Today I'm going to speak about the importance of girl child and what I am going to become in future. Nothing will stop me is a positive sentence, but overconfidence too. Whatever stops me, I will win against it and achieve my goal to become a doctor is a confidence I gained. As a doctor, I will never accept child abortion because each child is created for a purpose. One day, a religious person, when he was praying, asked God, God, why are people dying with so many deadly diseases and where the medicines are never found? God answered, I have created each child for a different purpose. When I create a child, I give it the knowledge to invent the cure for these deadly diseases. What you humans do is very wrong. Y'all just kill it and send it back to me. So, from now, let all of us start committing murder in the name of abortion and save girl child. To the girls across the world, I would like to say, count your blessings. Count your blessings. Never grumble for what you have. Try to make things better than what you are. Take pride when you have helped another girl to achieve their goal. Thank you.
I must stay conscious through the madness and chaos. I call on my angels. They say, oh, you stole little fate. Don't doubt it, don't doubt it. Victory is in my veins. I know it, I know it. And I will not negotiate. Just fight it, just fight it. I will transform. Cause when the fire's at my feet again, and the watches all start circling.
Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take up my right song. Grab up my right song. My power stand on. Starting right now, I'll be strong. I'll fight my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes. Cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me.
World of laughter, a world of cure, a world of hopes and a world of fear. That's how much that we care, there is time. We are aware it's a small world after all. 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 It's a small, small, world. There is just one moon and a golden sun and a smiling friendship to everyone. Through the mountains you wanna go.
And all my soul so weary when troubles come and my heart burden be. Then I am still and wait here in the silence till you come. Sit a while with me. You raise me up.
When there's a king who makes you stronger, stronger, just me, myself, and I. Who says I'm not perfect? Who says I'm not worth it? Who says I'm the only one that's hurting? Trust me, that's a part of beauty. Who says I'm not beautiful? Who say what you wanna say and let the words fall out? Honestly, I wanna see you be brave with what you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, I wanna see you be brave. Just wanna see you. I just wanna see you. I just wanna see you. I wanna see you be brave. I'm Titania.
Rights are women's rights, and women's rights are human rights. Hillary Clinton famously said in 2008, "It's up to us to fight for those rights and to work towards establishing equality for all." Hi everyone, myself Nandini. Did you know that some of the few countries that are the best environment for women and girl children are Denmark, Sweden, Norway, Netherlands, Canada, and Finland? Well, if you didn't, now you know. These countries didn't just achieve gender equality, they achieved equity. Equity is the fairness and impartiality shown among two or more groups. For me, equity is based on the view of people. Hence, for equity to take place, the view of people needs to change. We can only achieve equity in gender through women empowerment. This empowerment should be made socially, mentally, and educationally. And for this to happen, we girls should be given the right support and motivation. Ways we can find strength in ourselves are: never compare ourselves with others. we are unique in ourselves. Understand our strengths and weaknesses. Better our strengths and work on our weaknesses. Speak up. It's okay to be wrong. Expressing yourself is most important. These things can really boost and build our self-confidence. There are two powers in the world. One is the sword and the other is the pen. There is a third power stronger than both, that of women. This is a quote coined by Malala Yousafzai. Malala Yousafzai, a famous woman, was a brave person who had to face many adversities. She fought and even endangered her life for the right of education for the girl child. For her efforts, she received the Nobel Peace Prize and is known all over the world for her determination in helping girl children receive education. She believed that she could, so she did. Now, let's look at a few quotes by famous personalities. The day a woman can walk freely on the roads at night, that day we can say that India has received independence. Mahatma Gandhi. How can we effect change in the world when only half of it is invited or feels welcome to participate in the conversation? Emma Watson. The question isn't who is going to let me, it's who is going to stop me. Thank you.
सवेरा यहाँ तू है, सब वहाँ है जहाँ तू है, कदमों में तेरे जन्नतें बिछी हैं, जलवों में तेरे शोहरतें हैं।
खुदा की दुआ
तो पाँव को अपने जमा दे, जहाँ रास्ता ले आता है मंजिल वहाँ, जहाँ भी तू चाहे बना ले मकान, ये
तेरा बसेरा
सब की भलाई में।
Especially in the rural settings, where she is not looked upon as a burden, but as an asset to her family. I have a vision. It is a vision that one day, every girl child will be educated on par with the male child, without being partial to the fact that one day she may leave her home and enter another. I have a vision. It is a vision that one day a girl can go out on the streets, alone, at any time, without any fear that she will be harmed. I have a vision. It is a vision that one day, a girl is not thought of as a second option, but as one of the options for an important job. I have a vision. It is a vision that one day, my country will be a developed nation. Developed because the girl child is respected, nurtured and empowered to reach for the stars, to shatter the glass ceiling. Don't clip her wings, because today's girl child can be and do anything tomorrow. My voice, our future.
Oh. all smiles. I know what it takes to fool this town. I'll do it till the sun goes down and all through the night time. Yeah.
Oh yeah, I'll tell you what you wanna hear. Leave my sunglasses on while I shed a tear. It's never the right time.
Yeah.
I put my arm around to show you how strong I am. I put my arm around, I'll show you that I am. I'm unstoppable, I'm a boy show with no breaks. I'm invincible, yeah, I win every single game. I'm so powerful, I don't need batteries to play. I'm so confident, yeah, I'm unstoppable today. Unstoppable today, I'm unstoppable today. Break down, only alone I will cry out now. You'll never see what's hiding down, hiding out deep down. Yeah.
Who you are beautiful. You are precious, you are funny, you are never too much, you are always enough. You are powerful, you are worth dying for, you are world changing, and you and I are amazing and worth it of all creation. People say that you are useless.
I will protect a girl's rights till the end of my life. I believe that a girl has become a unique integral tag of society today. A girl child being born in a family is considered a taboo or a curse to the family. And I am here to tell you about how important and precious a girl is to humankind. The rights of a village girl differ from an urban girl in various ways. And the most important difference is the right to education. Every girl has the right to education. And apart from education, we have a lot more problems that girls face today. So why should we be silent? Why don't we fight for our rights? Why don't we tell the world what's happening? We have a rape in India every 15 minutes. Girls are still being buried alive in some parts of India as soon as they are born. Child marriage is still an issue. In villages, women are victims of many social evils such as harassment for dowry, divorce, and bigamy. Girls are not given the right to expression. Every girl who stands up for her rights is considered as a victim. We need to fight against what is happening. It is very easy to blame the government, but we need to understand that the government cannot do anything without our support. Let me give you a simple example. Suppose, say you have a chocolate and throw the wrapper down in spite of the dustbin being there. That means that the government had provided us the dustbin and our duty was to use it and protect the environment and make a change. The same way, if we don't raise our voice against the families who are getting their daughters married before the age of 18, and also against the rapists out there, we will never be able to bring a change in this world. Also, I would like to mention about the discrimination towards women in the US and UK especially. They are considered as terrorists just for being covered. In today's world, women are being paid for being exposed and those who are covered are getting arrested. They are referred to as oppressed women, and this is a serious issue. If a woman is free to show her body, why isn't she free to cover it? I personally have never understood the meaning of freedom nowadays. I believe to choose what she wants to show you and what she doesn't want to show you is what I call freedom.
Hello, my name is Audrey Joseph. I'm in Sacred Heart Girls High School, India, and equality to me means a non-patriarchal society. I once saw a survey where they asked women what they would do if men didn't exist for 24 hours. The answer that topped the list was take a walk. The second was wear what I want to. It is so unfortunate how such simple things have topped the list. Being a woman should not be this hard. I should not be judged for the clothes I wear, the people I'm with, or the little choices I make about what to do with my own body. Feminism is as simple as ABC. We want to be treated exactly the same way that men are, accorded the same respect, given the same opportunities. Fundamentally, the feminist movement is the same thing, whether liberal feminist, radical feminist, womanist, or post-feminist. We want women to have the opportunity to choose who they want to be. If a woman decides to be a housewife, we want it to be her decision, her choice. You can only choose when you have several options. When a woman decides to be a housewife, we want her to have the opportunity to be involved in the workforce at any point in time and be given equal pay. We want her to have the opportunity to be involved in politics. We want her to have the opportunity to go to space if she so desires, without anyone batting an eyelid or asking her who's going to cook for her husband while she's in Mars advancing humanity. Whatever a woman chooses should be her own decision. If she then decides that baking cookies and taking care of the home is her thing, fantastic. What feminists are fighting for is that every woman in the world be afforded the same amount of opportunities that her male counterparts have before she makes her choice. Also bear in mind that a woman can choose more than one option. We demand to be given the opportunities to eat what we want from the buffet of life. Feminism isn't about making women strong. Women are already strong. It's about changing the way the world perceives that strength. Women empowerment is a glossy term. It's shiny. Everyone wants it or seems to like it. Everybody talks about it. Very much like the environmental movements or the social responsibility issues, it is a socially desirable stand, making it difficult for people to speak against it. But at this intersection, it is important to note that the women empowerment is not just a homogeneous block of conversations. There are issues that are unspoken, as well as fragmentation and polarization of this movement and the discourses surrounding it. Personally, I deem women empowerment as any step women take beyond the perceived limit or the structural borderline to achieve their personal freedom. A woman should be two things: who and what she wants to be.
Breathing in, breathing out.